My name is James. I am the president of the Filipino American Student Association.
And my name is Maverick Tolentino, and I'm the public relations officer, FASA-CUP.
And we would like to thank all you guys for spending your time with us tonight at our first ever Filipino Cultural Night.
Before we start off with this evening's agenda, we'd just like to acknowledge the presence of very important people here tonight.
Okay, well, I was going to welcome Dr. Francisco, but I don't see her in the crowd yet. She might be running a little late.
We'll welcome her later.
Yes, we'd like to welcome our special guests in the corner. And our special guests over here, we have some friends from some other schools, including University of Oregon and Portland State University. We have a UP alum here too.
And I'd like to ask everybody to please rise. And I invite Fredelis Misai, a UP alum, to sing our beloved Philippine national anthem.
Sa dagat at bundok, sa simoy at sa langit mong bughaw, may dilag ang tula at awit sa paglayang minamahal. Ang kisap ng watawat mo'y tagumpay na nagniningning, ang bituin at araw niya kailan pa man di magdidilim. Lupa ng araw na aming ligaya na pag may mga api ang mamatay ng dahil sa'yo.
Alright, so just a little question. Who here is Filipino? Raise your hand.
Put your hands up.
Hands up high. Yeah. Cool.
So now another question. Who here has been to the Philippines? Oh yeah. Raise it up high.
Who's lived in the Philippines?
That's cool. James, have you ever been in the Philippines?
I have. Been a number of times. I've been there actually 6 times. The last time was like 3 years ago, visiting my family in the Philippines. My mom's Filipino, although I look white, I am half white, half Filipino. My mom, she's from Iloilo, a city on the island of Panay in the Visayas, which is in the middle of the Philippines. And it's lovely visiting. I always love seeing my family there.
Yeah, great.
What about you, Maverick?
Last time I've been there, I think, was 2012. I'm actually from American Samoa, but I'm full Filipino. So yeah, my mom's from Bulacan, and my dad's from Batangas. So I have this really deep Filipino accent when I talk Tagalog. So you guys can hear it probably. But it's really cool that FASA-CUP here has a group like just dedicated to the culture of the Philippines, and it's so great to be in touch with my roots, especially being so far away from home, and you know, just missing Philippines so much. And all the street vendors with so much good food and stuff like that.
So we're really trying to bring that type of culture out here into the University of Portland. So FASA-CUP, that's actually short for the Filipino American Student Association of University of Portland. We're a relatively new club. We've been around, what, now like 3 years? We started in 2012. I remember I was part of the original board. Now I came to school, I was like, where's the Filipino club at? And people were like, we don't have one. Like, oh, it's kind of lame. And you know, like, you should be president. I'm like, nah. So I wasn't for like 2 years. But we got some friends together. We met up in the Cove, one of our cafeterias. And we just kind of sat down. We're like, all right, let's make this a real thing. And start scheduling meetings, sending out emails, hanging up flyers. People started showing up. you know, it was really kind of joyful to kind of start fostering that type of community and just seeing the friendships that develop out of that. So I think our dancers are ready. You guys good? Cool. All right, so now please sit back and enjoy our rendition of the Philippines creation story as told by our FASA UP group through music and dance. Thank you.
When the world first began, there was no land. Only the sea and the sky, and between them was a crow. One day, this bird, which had nowhere to land, grew tired of flying around. So she stirred up the sea until it threw its waters against the sky. The sky, in order to restrain the sea, showered upon its many, many islands until it could no longer rise, but instead flow back and forth, making a tide. Then the sky ordered the crow to land on one of the islands, to build her nest, and to leave the sea and the sky in peace. Now at this time, the land breeze and the sea breeze were married, and they had a child, which was bamboo. One day, when this bamboo was floating about on the water, it struck the feet of the crow, who was on the beach. The bird, angry that anything should strike it, pecked at the bamboo, and out of one section came a man. Malakas, strong one, and from the other, a woman, maganda, which means beautiful one. Tonight, the bamboo will symbolize the traditional style dance of the Philippines. Dinikling, translating to tikling life, imitates the movement of a common rail bird, the tikling. The tikling walks, jumps, and moves throughout the marshes where farmers plant their rice seeds, causing much devastation to the crops. In response, farmers set up bamboo traps for the birds that snap shut when a bird steps inside. Ladies and gentlemen, I present the traditional tikling dance.
Thank you.
fish to see what should be done with these two. And it was decided that they should marry.
To celebrate this marriage, the Pandango Rinconada will be performed. This style of waltz is similar to Spanish Pandango. The colonization of Spanish rule in the Philippines played a big role in shaping Filipino culture. There are many variations of the waltz often performed during major gatherings. This Pandango Rinconada is popular amongst the people of the Rinconada district in Nagua, Camarines Sur. The love of this couple is expressed with the slow and quick rhythm of the music. Ladies and gentlemen, sit back, relax, and enjoy this couple waltz in celebration of the marriage of the first man and woman, Malakas and Maganda. Thank you. Wasn't it that beautiful? How about another palakpak on June's class? Thank you. Now we are at our 20-minute intermission, so if you haven't had the chance to get some food, we have food on that side. We have plate of adobo with rice and kefir salad for $8.50, vegetable pancit bowl for $7.50, and banana lumpia with ice cream for
$4. Hope you enjoy your food. We're going to go back to our story. So we're going to go in character.
Remember we left off at the wedding, marriage?
So, we would like to dedicate this next song to our married couple in our story. And to anybody else who's married.
Believe the children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside.
Of all.
I think that's my favorite Filipino karaoke song. Okay, let's get back to the story. Okay, many children were born to the couple, and from them came all the different races of people. After a while, the parents grew very tired of having so many idle, useless children around. They wished to be rid of them, but they knew of no place to send them to. Time went on, and the children became so numerous that the parents enjoyed no peace.
Now it happened that those who went in the hidden rooms of the house later became the chiefs of the islands, and those who concealed themselves in the walls became slaves, while those who ran outside were free men. Those who hid in the stove became dark-skinned people. Those who fled to the sea were gone many years, and when the children came back, they became people of many cultures. This is why today we see such diversity in our languages and cultures.
Acknowledgements we'd like to make. Summer love, right?
Wait, James. Let's just acknowledge everybody for literally rocking the stage tonight. Let's give everybody a hand.
Literally rock the stage.
You guys see that hole that Grand Canyon just came out of nowhere? Yeah. But anyways, we'd like to just make a few acknowledgements to people who could have made this possible. So the hip hop routine that you just saw, that was choreographed by Michael Solitario. Where are you at? He's back there.
Yeah, could you come up please, Michael? Michael, we got something special for you. It's a surprise, so just come up.
Yeah, Michael.
Alright, so we gave him a tabo full of goodies. So let's all give a round of applause for Michael. Alright, so and for the children's dance and waltz, it was choreographed by UP alumna Diana Arce. Yeah. Come up on stage, please. Yeah. And we also have a surprise for her.
Yeah.
I wonder what it is. It's also a tabo full of goodies. What a sweet
gift. And as you may have seen, this guy and my lovely girlfriend and vice president, Christine over there. It's the greatest love of all. So, a little round of applause for them.
And also, we'd like to acknowledge the traditional Tinikling dance choreographer.
Choreographer?
I don't know. Alright, so, and I would like to acknowledge him, Isaac Amaral. Can you come up, please? We also have a surprise for you. Guess what? It's another tabo. Yeah, come so people can see you.
Everyone wants a tabo. Check in your chairs.
Oh. There you go.
Yeah.
You can shower now. That was a cool kind of joke. Anyways.
And then just some shout outs to some of the characters in the story portion. We got the Sea Breeze, that's Roxanne and Aldrich. Where's the Roxanne? Aldrich, can you step out? Oh, there he is, yeah. We got the Land Breeze, there's Lavinia, and then Sean, thank you. And then we got the Crow, Arden, and Malakas is Louie, and Maganda is Camila. Thank you.
Yeah, I think we ran out of tabos already, so it's okay. So also, we'd like to give out two special awards today. And we'd like to first acknowledge the person or the FASA member who had best attendance. I think he attended 10 out of 13 meetings. Oh, I gave a hint. I'd like to call on TJ Hidalgo. Look at his reaction. He didn't know. He didn't know. Look at his reaction. All right. You want a tabo? Sorry, we ran out already. So come on. It's like graduation. Where are you? Here you go. Take a picture.
We also have the MVP award, it's short for Most Valued Filipino. And that is Camille, noted for her awesome dancing.
Congratulations! Another round of applause!
Also, a shout out to all the graduating seniors and the FASA board for making this possible. And Freddie! Freddie, she helped choreograph. Where is she at? And the singer of the anthem, thank you.
She also helped MC and tell the story too, so it's really cool. She's wearing a very sequin pink. Yeah, ooh! And can I have some please favorite?
Let's share. All right. And then we were supposed to do this earlier, apologies guys. But we have a presentation from our friends over at PCHRP, the Portland Committee for Human Rights in the Philippines. And PSU Kaibiga, our friends of the Filipino Club down at Portland State University. So yeah, you guys want to come up here or I can bring the mic down there? This is Antonio.
Hey guys, once again we are doing our little fundraiser for our terrarium, some little plant things. For my friend, we're sending her to the Philippines to do relief work. And she's trying to do this fundraiser to help fund for her trip. So if you guys are interested, come by and check it out. They're super cute. They're very low maintenance plants. And yeah, thank you guys.
Thank you. All right, so we're done with the acknowledgments and congratulations. Next, we're gonna move on to the games. So
yeah, games always part of the party.
Yeah. So does anyone remember what those two big sticks are called? Someone raise their hand.
Bamboo.
They are bamboo. In the Philippines, what do they call them? Not the sticks. The dance. I'm sorry. The dance. You guys were here. Nope.
Oh,
what's it called?
The very handsome MC was talking about it earlier.
The tinny cling, guys. The tinny cling. So who thinks they can do the tinny cling? Who wants to try it?
Oh, right there. Right. I saw the hand. You have to come up.
All right. Let's give a hand for Becca. Okay. So I don't know if you guys can see from where you're sitting, but with the tinny plane, it goes with the rhythm of a boom. Wait. Boom, clap, boom, clap, clap. Boom, clap, clap, boom, clap, clap. So if you mess up, your ankles break. No, I'm just kidding. Yeah, they get hit by that. They hit by the bamboo. They're light, so you'll be fine if you mess up. All right. What we're gonna do is, if you win a prize.
No. But first, let's introduce our lovely contestant here. Contestant number one, what's your name?
Becca.
Becca, what a beautiful name. And what's your last name?
Chavez.
Great. I don't know what to say after.
Did you go to UP? Are you an alum?
I am.
Awesome. Cool. Okay, so what we're gonna do is you gotta master the tinny cling, but we're gonna keep it real short since I know people gotta go places. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna have to jump in. Here,
James, why don't you show them?
I'll show
you. All right. okay?
All right, so we're trying to think of like a reasonable number. So if you can do three times in a row without touching the bamboo or tripping over yourself, hurting yourself, just do it smoothly, you will win a prize.
Yeah. And you can't stop, okay? It has to be in a row. Okay, yeah.
None of that. But we'll give you about how many tries should we give? One try or two tries?
Two tries? No, I think one.
One?
Yeah, one.
All right, this is the test.
It's one.
Okay, are you ready, Becca?
There you go. Hey, clap. Wow, that was awesome. Like, where are you? Hey, you're great.
She made me look like a big guy.
Becca Chavez. She hustled us, folks. She hustled us. She knew how to do this. And she has a wonderful choco pie and fruit lychee jelly. Yum.
Give a round of applause. All right, so since we're limited on prizes, we will give one more lucky contestant a chance to win a prize. So, who's the skilled soul out there?
Iman, what? Iman, did I see your hand up?
Anybody. You can put this
who wants
on
to
your,
do it?
You can put this on your resume. I did the Diddy Bling at PCN.
Come on, guys. Oh yeah, right there. I think Iman right there. Iman, is your name Iman in the back there?
In the glasses!
Yeah, yeah. There you go!
Alright, he's my friend, so I have to pick on him.
Yeah, definitely, so...
Alright, why don't I'll just do it one more time so you can see it up close and then you give it a shot.
Alright. Yeah, that's it.
There you go.
All right. So, what was your name again?
Emmanuel.
What's your last name?
Sion.
Okay. Good. So, let's cheer on Emmanuel Sion. Let's give him a round of applause. All right. It's for the prize.
The audience has voted.
That's good. It's good. Great. Hey, oh. I'll see you later, bro.
We still have a prize. We need someone to win this prize. Otherwise, I might take it home. Oh. Danny?
All right.
Danny! Yeah. Would you like me to show you again? Or yes? Yes.
What's your name?
Danny. And you just gotta go, so you start off on the left side, or if you want to start on the right, doesn't matter. And then you have to go to the other side and back three times. Yeah. Pull up the trousers.
Pancit Canton! Yeah. We had another tabo all along.
Straight from Cuban.
Alright. Okay, so now we'd like to ask a special request from our adults in the audience. Would you like to show us how it's done? Try it out. I'll take off your shoes first. All right, all right.
And who's our lucky contestant's name?
Vivian Tadeo.
Okay.
Do you want me to do it again, or you can probably show me?
Oh, pay the ball, pay the ball. Sing it up, sing it up. Sunflower grinders. Thank you so much, y'all. Thank you. Alright. And we also like to thank our clappers, Roxanne and Lavinia. Yay. Yeah. Alright. So we're gonna move on to our next game. Okay, it's not gonna involve long bamboo sticks. But we can try to go off the stage. Okay, so okay, 10. Okay, this game, let me explain the game first. It was popularized by Wawa Wee, if you guys remember that. Wawa Wee Willie Rebellion Man. It's called Hep Hep Parade. Who knows what that game is? Hep Hep Parade. Alright. Alright, this is gonna test your attention span, kind of. Alright, so we'd like to call on 10 people who want to try, and only one will win. And any brave contestant who would like to try?
Jump up there.
Hep Hep Parade? Right there. Come here, bro. We got one right here. 10 contestants. We got 2 right now. Diane. Let's go, Diane. Sarah, Caitlin.
Drew.
Come on.
All right, who's on the back?
Andrea. I see your hand.
Okay,
Andrea.
Who's Andrea?
Andrea.
And who's that? Right there. What's her name?
Yeah.
Do we get one to 10?
All right, I think count. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and who's 10?
Andrea.
10.
Oh.
Alright.
Right.
We have chance. Oh, Andrea, come back. You're looking for 11.
Let's go, Andrea.
Alright, so. Okay. Alright, so Hep Hep Parade is about like hand motions, okay? So when I point the mic to you, like this,
you say hep hep. Hep hep, slide down.
Hep hep. I point to the next time, it's gonna be hooray. Okay? Hep hep, hooray. Okay, contestants, practice that. Hep hep, hooray. Hep hep, hooray. So, for example, if I point to you,
you're gonna say hep hep.
Yeah, I'll do the motion and the words.
So,
hep hep, hooray. Hep
hep, hooray.
Perfect. You guys got it. Okay. If they miss a beat, you guys be the judges too. Okay, because I can't see everything.
And
everything.
He can be sneaky. He can be sneaky. You know. Watch out. He can point to you twice.
All right. So step up a little bit. Step up. Don't be shy. All right. We're gonna start. We're ready to finish the practice time. We're gonna start. Okay. 3, 2. Thank you. Sorry. Thanks, Caitlin. All right, so you guys got that. See? Okay. Okay.
Hooray.
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 Hooray. Hooray. Hooray. Hooray.
Hooray. It's tough.
Oh. Oh, it's a challenge, huh, guys? Do we have like eight left? Or nine, if I don't know.
Eight, nine.
I'm done with my math credits. I'm done with it. Alright, 3, 2.
Hit it. Hooray.
Hit it.
Hooray.
Okay, alright. Alright, let's go. 3, 2, 1.
Hip hip, hooray.
Hip hip,
hooray.
Hip hip, hooray.
Hip hip, hooray.
Hip hip, hooray.
Do we accept that? Do we accept that?
Yeah. Okay, I heard a clap, but I don't know. What do you guys think?
Accept? Okay, accept. Alright, play on. Dodge a bullet. 3, 2, 1.
Hip hip, hooray.
Hip hip, hooray. Hip hip,
hooray.
Hip hip,
hooray.
Hip hip.
Hooray. Hooray.
Hooray. Hooray. Hooray. Ooh, strike. Alright, we're down to 7. Alright, when we get to 5, we'll change it up. Okay.
Hooray.
Hooray. Thanks, Sarah. Alright, we're down to 6. 6 lucky contestants.
Hooray.
All right, now we're down to the top 5 contestants of Hep Hep Hooray. Give them a round of applause, everybody. All right, now we're gonna mix it up. We're just gonna mix it up a little bit, okay?
Round two.
This is gonna be Hooray, Hep Hep, okay? I know you guys hate me for it, but we're gonna do it. Hooray, Hep Hep, everybody try it.
Hooray,
Hep Hep,
hooray.
Hep Hep, okay? 3, 2, 1. Right there, oh. The mind is such a wondrous thing, it's just crazy. Oh my goodness, all right. So again, hooray, Hep Hep. Participants, go.
Hooray,
Hep Hep.
That's it?
Hep Hep. All right, let's go, 3.
Let's go, Rachel.
Yeah.
Hooray.
Hooray first, okay? We can switch up a little bit, okay? Okay, 3, 2.
Hooray.
Alright,
let's try.
And our top three. Alright. Okay, let's go back to normal. I feel like going back to normal, okay? Let's go back to normal. Okay, 3. Hep hep hooray. Hep hep hooray. 3, 2. Yeah, back to normal. Hep hep hooray. 3, 2, 1. Oh. Alright, top two. Wait, what's your name?
Megan,
let's talk about a round of applause for Megan. What's your name? Rachel, let's talk about a round of applause for Rachel. Now, they're doing play, Hep Hep Hooray. And I've been told I'm really tricky on this last two, because we played this during meetings, and like people just hate me for making them lose. So let's try this, I hope you guys don't hate me. Okay. So we're gonna do normal first, okay? So you guys get it, okay? 3, 2, 1. Grand prize! It's what's in there? Fastest the UP shirt? And Pocky! And banana ketchup! Liquid seasoning! This is not sponsored by one of the ones! Oh my god! Oh, I should have joined that, guys! Filipino started by, you guys heard that so funny. That was great. I love doing that. It's fun. Alright, yeah, so
I hope you guys enjoyed the show.
I hope you did. I did, honestly.
Yeah. That concludes our show. Thank you for coming to FASA.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. You guys are great. You guys are a great audience. Love you guys.
Have a good night, everyone.
Nice to see you.
Be safe.